We're going to do joint mobilisation. So we're going to start with pata pata. Follow along. Okay. Hands on shoulders and circle. And round. And circle. And round. Circle. And round. And up. And round. Now reverse. Try and touch your elbows at the front. Nice. Then up. And touch at the front. Up. And touch. And up. And touch. Now wrists and arms. And three. And four. And back. One. And two. And three. And four. And hands on hips. Big, slow hip circles. Think about your tailbone. And the other way. Describing a big circle. And now a figure of eight. Think about one hip leading the way. And the other way. Feet together, hands on knees, and stick your bottom out. And slow circle for the ankles and knees. The other way. Now standing tall on your left leg, foot out. Either you'll circle your ankle in the air or put your foot down if you need. And back. Good. The other one. And back. That's it. Hold on if you need. And now walking through for your toe joints. Apart, make sure you've got space behind you and swing. Swing. And now, as if you've got a scarf flinging over your shoulder. And we're going to go straight on into the next one, which is our Qigong. So, if you find space to look in the mirror, make sure you've got space. So, these are these. Eight exercises, and push, and down, and push, and down. Now one up, one down, push, and hold the ball, push, and hold the ball, and push. And hold the ball and push. Hold the ball and drop. And now we're going to do cow gazing at the moon. So we lift up, swivel at the waist, push as if we're against a wall and back to the middle. Turn and push and back to the middle. Turn. And push and back to the middle and turn and push and back to the middle. And now we're going to do the bow and arrow. So we're up, we pull back and we push out and back, push and pull. Think about the fingertips reaching up to the ceiling. Push and pull. Nice. Shoulders down. Yes. And back. And now we're going to do side bends, up with the right, reach the corner. And up and down. Reach up first, over to the corner. Nice, and up and down. Reach up to the corner. And up and down. Reach up to the corner. And up. Thumbs with fingers over the top. Imagine some elastic between the two. And as you push forward and pull back, you resist with that elastic. And back. Turn the fist over, punch and pull back. That's good. Shoulders down. Good. And again, push and pull back. Really feel that resistance. And now we're going to reach forward. If somebody's pulling your hips back at the same time, and reach and down. Push up really strongly through your legs. And reach and down. And push up. Reach. Down, push up through your legs and reach and down and push up through your legs. And now with the bits of your wrist at the back, little jig. Good. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go into our qigong, our standing, our tree hugging. What tree shall we have today? A skinny tree. How about a ginkgo? We'll have a ginkgo tree today. Okay. The ginkgo trees, the prehistoric trees. So we've got a nice ginkgo tree that we're hugging. So just check your feet and your toes are pointing forward and your feet are parallel to each other. And now here we are. We're in my back garden actually, because I've got a ginkgo tree. And it's still got some leaves on it, which are bright yellow. They're those ones that look like fans. And it's slightly windy. So we're standing in a lovely autumn day, but every so often, a few leaves drop on our shoulders and on our head from our ginkgo tree. But just like the ginkgo tree, we're standing tall, with our roots planted deeply. Our feet are planted in the soil. We can feel our little toe joint and our big toe joint planted in the soil, and the middle of our heel pushing down too. We can imagine a little balloon between our knees, holding our knees apart. We can imagine a little balloon under each armpit, supporting our arms. And between each finger, there's a little balloon helping our fingers suspend in the air. Between our thumb and our first finger, between our first finger and our middle, between our middle and our fourth, between our fourth and our little, there's a little balloon between each of those. And we also have balloons resting under our ears and on our shoulders, keeping our shoulders down and our neck supported. And our head is reaching up as high as it can go, like the ginkgo tree. And we can remember that ginkgo trees have been around since the dinosaurs. So we can just imagine how strong the tree is, how it can be resilient and resist all pests and problems. And that yet the leaves are so delicate, that lovely yellow with the fan shape. And they're just some gently swaying as they fall down in this little breeze of the autumn day. And on the floor of our garden, we can see a few leaves from the ginkgo lying around. And they don't seem to wither, but there are also some beech leaves, which are going a bit mushy now, and some oak leaves. And when we look in the trees around us, we can hear and see the squirrels darting about the branches, trying to find the last food before the winter. And they're jumping lightly from branch to branch. Just hold that position there. And then let's just brush the leaves off our picnic table. And brush and circle and feel a bit of energy under the palms of our hands. Lovely. Then we take our thumb and put it on our navel and the hand on the belly and then the other hand over the top and let the energy and the heat come back to your center.